Hello again, this is Professor Shannon Gracie on section 1.6 from the Blitzer Introductory and Intermediate Algebra text. Now we'll be discussing subtraction of real numbers. And the beauty of subtraction of real numbers is that it's all the same as addition of real numbers, except what you're doing is you're changing that subtraction symbol to adding the opposite. So, when you're done with your homework, you should be able to subtract real numbers, simplify additions and subtractions, and then use the definition of subtraction to identify terms, and use subtraction definition to simplify algebraic expressions, and we want to solve problems involving subtraction. So here is the warm-up. Go ahead and pause the movie and do the warm-up. All right, so let's see how you did. So this will yield a result of 1/2 times 2x minus 1/2 times 7. That's using which law? Good, the distributive law or distributive property. And then we'll be adding to that 3x's. So the 1/2 times 2x just gives us 1x, and then we'll have minus 7/2 plus 3x's, and notice that we have like terms here. So at the end of the day, we will get 4x's minus 7/2. How'd you do? Good. Okay, so for the second problem, we will have the opposite of negative x plus the opposite of 5. That's distributing that negative throughout. And then I'm going to go ahead and do this 3 times 2 to get 6, and we will have the 5x minus 1 remaining in the parentheses. And notice I just distributed this minus throughout the parentheses. So the opposite of x is positive x. We will have minus 5. And then distributing the 6 throughout, we will get plus 30x's minus 6. Now we've got like terms, x and then positive 30x, and remember that constants are always like terms. So we will have a result of 31x's, and then negative 5 minus 6 is really just like negative 5 plus negative 6, which we learned last time, and that'll yield a result of 31x minus 11. We're all done. Put your happy box and we go from there. Okay, so for all real numbers A and B, A minus B is equal to A plus the opposite or negative B. And like I said, we learned all those rules for addition last time. So the beauty of this section is you just get to hone your addition of real number skills. There's one little additional element of changing a subtraction symbol to adding the opposite. Okay? So to subtract B from A, add the opposite or additive inverse of B to A. The result of subtraction is called the difference. Okay. So there's a procedure one can use to subtract real numbers. So this procedure consists of changing the subtraction operation to addition. And remember, nothing in math is free, so you have to change the sign of the number being subtracted in order to pay for that. And then your third step is just to add using the rules we learned in section 1.5. So here we go. Using the guidelines, this is equivalent to negative 16 plus the opposite of negative 9. So this minus was changed by adding the opposite. Now, this will yield a result of negative 16 plus positive 9, because the opposite of negative 9, this stuff here, is positive 9. And now, using what we learned from before, we'll have this is equivalent to negative 7. Okay, so next up, and if you want to, actually, you should pause the movie and see if how you do on the next three problems. Okay, let's see how you did. So this will be 16 plus negative 20. So again, this minus was changed to plus a negative. So this would be negative 4, because the absolute value of negative 20 is 20, and we'll be subtracting 16 from that to get 4, and you attach the negative sign, since that was attached to the number with the larger absolute value. And number 3, we would get negative 6 plus negative 32. They've got the same sign. And again, you know, this minus was changed into plus a negative. So we are going to get 6 plus 32 is 38. They're both negative, so the negative stays there. All right, number 4. Now, actually, if you think about it, 10.2 minus 0.2, we can just do that regularly. You know how to do that regular subtraction. So do you see that's going to be 10.0? And then we'll do plus the opposite of negative 5.1. So 10.2 minus 0.2 gave us 10.0, and then this minus was changed into plus a negative. So we'll have 10.0 plus a positive 5.1, which yields a result of 15.1. Okay, so now the next example gets a little more in depth. We want to use all of our mad addition and subtraction skills to simplify these problems. Okay, so go ahead and pause the movie and do the next two examples and see our next two items from example two. See how you do. Okay, let's see how you did. We will get, so 3 times 4 gives us 12 x's. I'm going to distribute this minus through. So we will get minus 2 x's plus 21. So the minus distributed, because you've got your finding, do you see that minus a minus is positive? So now, 12 x's minus 2 x's, so these here are like terms, right? So we're going to get 10 x's plus 21. There you go. Okay. Next up we have, notice these parentheses around the x plus 5, they're not really doing anything except for kind of grouping this x plus 5, but this positive won't change anything. So let's go ahead and remove those parentheses since they're not really doing us any favors there. Now I'm going to go ahead and distribute this minus 2 throughout. So we'll have minus 2 times x minus 2 times negative 11, and then we'll have a minus 2 times 3y. So this is our distributive law, where that one is headed there. So we've got, actually we can combine these two terms that have x's. 9x plus 1x is 10x's plus 5. We've got minus 2x minus a minus is going to be positive, so we're going to have plus 22, and then we'll have minus 6y. Now do you see we have like terms for the 10x and the negative 2x? So this will yield a result of 8x's. The 5, positive 5 and positive 22 are like terms. So we'll have plus 27 and then minus 6y for our last term. We're all set. Okay, so this section's a nice short section. I bet you're going to be very, very sad that you finished so quickly. Okay, so applications. This line graph illustrates the value of Sarah's car in dollars from the year 2001 to the year 2007. So this graph, if you notice, that in year 2001, so let me get the little hand going. So in the year 2001, right here, her car was valued at $24,000. Well, in the next year, she was at $22,500, etc. So it's decreasing in value. Right, so how much was Sarah's car worth in 2005? So here, if you just kind of look, okay, 2005, let's see where I hit the graph. Okay, and so here it is. Her car, actually I'm blocking the number, was valued at $14,500. And then how much more was Sarah's car worth in 2002? So here in 2002, let's see what it was worth. We said that in 2002, remember her car was worth, we verbalized this a minute ago, her car was worth $22,500. So basically, to figure out how much more her car was worth, we would say $22,500 minus $14,500, and then we'll get, you know, 12 minus 4 is 8. So do you see that answering the question, we would say Sarah's car was worth $8,000 more in 2002. And we're all set, folks. Have a fabulous day.